Hello everybody, and we're about to continue our Let's Play series of Dark Souls 3. In our last episode, we entered the Ring City, and now we're going to be working our way through the inner wall area, I believe. Okay. So, we went that way already. We came in that way. That way's locked for now. So I think we are going this way. We also did bring back our pyromancies, just because there are a lot of dark-resistant enemies in this area. Okay, let's see what we can find now. Oh! Death at every corner. Let's just reset. No need to go into the new area already crippled. These are fun enemies. Looks like they build a curse on us. That's nice. Let's see, people have not been walking through here very much. Lots of webs. Oh my god. That's our first time seeing a ringed knight. Okay, do we go this way first? Oh. Titanite chunk. Kind of like big old turtles. It's like clerics, kind of. That's what I assume they are, because it kind of looks like the cleric outfit. Interesting attack they got. There's like a dark miracle almost that follows you.
Hmm.
Oh, there's our friend. Can't hit him from here, I don't think. Shriving stone. See, every one of these has a sword, it looks like. All the statues. I think that plays into the riddle with Madeir. Because the one statue that doesn't have a sword later on leads to the actual passage to where Madeir is. I believe. Okay, we got a bunch of big guys coming. That's gonna be fun. Where is the third one? There he is. Can come over this way. Knight over there already waiting for us. There's one guy down. Let's see if we can plunge this one. Close. Okay, one more to go. Midnight Chunk.
Speak thee the name of God, thine own God, if thou canst recall. Ah, then thou'st not forgotten. Perhaps 'tis why we may converse. I am known as Shira, servant to the Princess Filianor, matriarch of the church. They who are kin to God's name are surely kin to the terrors of the dark. Please, I bid thee take not from the princess her peace or rest. As the fire waneth, does she lie by the dark, all for the sake of man. Thou'st a kind heart to speak to a captive such as I. It is no surprise thou rememberest our God. May I ask thee a kindness? Perhaps thou'st beheld the lone dragon that inhabiteth this city. Medir is his name, and the arch-dragons are his forebears. He once railed against the dark, but was by dark afflicted. Now here, returned, he remaineth, to watch over the sleeping princess, true to the old court. And yet, I would have thee put the dragon to rest, before the dark consumeth him, and his vows are forgot. I offer my sincerest gratitude, thou who art kin to God's name. Please, take this.
Sacred Chime of Filianor.
I have asked a thing most terrible of thee. May this token of thanks be of aid. I beg of thee, before the dark can...
Okay, awesome. Let's check out that item real quick. Sacred Chime blessed by Princess Filianor, Matriarch of the Church. Filianor's favor knows no boundaries, and this sacred chime expands the range of vicinity, affecting miracles that heal, cure, or provide other enhancements. Okay, so that would probably not work well for us, since we primarily deal with dark miracles. But, if you were dealing with regular ones, it's probably pretty awesome. Titanite Chunk. Titanite Chunk. Oh, there he is. Wolf rank plus 3. I'd like to say that was Alva. And I think this is the Black Witch set, which is pretty cool looking, actually. Let's take a look. The purple hat of the witch Zuli, who intended to seduce Alva the Wayfarer, but eventually became his closest supporter, spending her entire life with him. The pointed hat is a symbol of heretical magical crafts, and Zuli wore hers with an unspoken, deep sense of pride. And the Black Witch garb. The purple garb of the witch Zuli, who intended to seduce Alva the Wayfarer, but eventually became his closest supporter, spending her entire life with him. It is said that Zuli the Witch, who was never loved, nor loved another, experienced all manner of misfortune, and yet in the end found her purpose in life. So, can just take a quick look at what it looks like. I don't think it's going to look as good, just because it's got our backs hanging out a little bit, and we are all hollowed, but it is a pretty cool looking set. Okay, let's head on over. Well, who was that? Gem. Oh, there's more of those guys? I thought it was just the three of them. Oh, Lord. Okay. Three more. Back it up over here. That's one. I think this guy, we're just gonna run past. I'd like to say, that we have a bonfire very soon. Yes. Okay, I think this is a great stopping point for us. We did the inner ringed wall. In our next episode, we will take on the ringed city streets. Okay. I'd like to thank everybody for tuning in, and we'll be talking again real soon.